Hello everyone, welcome back to the series on Indian Mathematics, Kanita Ratnakosha. We will start looking at recurring decimals, fractions that can be expressed as recurring decimals, for example, fractions like 1 by 19. So let's look at how we can easily evaluate these fractions and to any number of decimals that are needed. So for the first one, we will do in flag division just to get used to the process, and then we will identify the pattern in it. So let's say I am dividing 19. I will use 2 bar 1 instead of 19 as the divisor and the flag digit, and there is 1. So there has to be one flag digit. So it's whatever comes in the quotient is all is decimals. And then let me add zeros. So let's say I want to work it out to some 7 or 8 decimals. So I can work out to as many number of decimals I want. So let's start dividing. 2, 1 goes 0 times. So that is 10 carried forward, no adjustment, revised dividend is 10, that is 5, 2 5s are 10, no carry forward, adjustment is plus 5 because the flag digit is negative, 2 2s are 4, 10, plus 2, that is 12, divided by 2 is 6, no carry forward, plus 6, divided by 2 is 3, then no carry forward, plus 3, divided, that is 3, 3 divided by 2 is 1, 1 carried forward, plus 1 gives me 11, divided by 2 is 5 times, 10, plus 5 gives me 15, divided by 2 is 7 times, 1, plus 7, that is 17, that's 8 times, 1, plus 8, that is 18, that gives me 9 times, and this can carry on like this. So if you notice, there is a pattern here. So let's look at what it is. So the answer is this 0.052163 0.052631 etc. is the answer of 1 by 19 expressed as a recurring decimal. So if we change the writing pattern, the pattern is, so it is 1 by 19, right? So we always take one more than this. Then the digit next to the 9, so that is 2. So I will divide every step I will divide by 2. So I will start dividing 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is 2 zeros are 0 time. The remainder I write next to it as a subscript, right? So that is 10. So 1 I divide by 2, 0 is the quotient, 1 is the remainder. Then this 10 I divide by 2 again, that is 5. See, I get the second digit. This 5 I divide by 2 again, I get 2 as the quotient and 1 as the remainder. Then this is 12. See, this is 12, here it is 12. 12 I divide by 2, I get 6. 6 I divide by 2, I get 3. 3 I divide by 2, I get 1 as the quotient and 1 as the remainder. So 11 I divide by 2, 5 as the quotient, 1 as the remainder. 15 I divide by 2, 7 is the quotient, 1 is the remainder. Then 17 I divide by 2, 8 is the quotient, 1 is the remainder. 18 I divide by 2, 9 is the quotient. Then 9 I divide by 2, 4 is the quotient, 1 is the remainder. Then 14 I divide by 2, it is 7. 7 I divide by 2 is 3 and 1. 13 I divide by 2 is 6 and 1. 16 I divide by 2 is 8. 8 I divide by 2 is 4. 4 I divide by 2 is 2 again. 2 I divide by 2 is 1 again. Now 1, I have come to the numerator again, and after this it will repeat. So then 1 divided by 2 is 0, 10, and as you can observe, then 10 divided by 2. So from here onwards it will repeat. So we have so many terms in the recurring decimal. After this, all the terms will repeat. So this is how I can easily start writing the answer for a fraction where the denominator is ending in 9. Let me look at one more example. Let's say I was dividing 11 by 19. So 11 by 19. I always take one more than this one. So this is 2 divided by 2. So divide by 2, 0 point. Then start dividing 11 by 2. 11 by 2 is 5 and 1 is the remainder. Then 15. Then 15 divided by 2, 7, and 1 is the remainder. 17 divided by 2 is 8, 1 is the remainder, this is 9, 4 and 1 is the remainder, 7, then 3, 1 is the remainder, 6, 1 is the remainder, 8, 4, 2, 1, 0, 1 is the remainder, 5, 2 2s are 12, 6, 3, 2, 1, that is 1 and 11. 1 and 1. So I again came to 11, which is my numerator, and after this the whole thing will repeat. So 5, 7, etc. So if I have to write the answer, it will be 0, 5, 7, 8, 9, 4, 7, 3, 6, 8, 4, 2, 1, 0, 5, 2, 6, 3, 1. After this, the whole thing will repeat. Yeah. So this is how you can very easily write answers of fractions where the denominator is ending in 9. There is also a shortcut. So 19 minus 11, if I take the difference between the numerator and the denominator is 8. So, and I see where I got 8. I got 8 here. And if you notice, the numbers on both the sides add to 9. So for example, 5 and 4 add to 9, 7 and 2 add to 9, 8 and 1 add to 9, 9 and 0 add to 9. So if you can calculate to, as you calculate, if you get the difference between the numerator and the denominator, after that you can easily start writing the numbers, because there will be 9 minus the first digit and so on. Okay, that's a shortcut, not doesn't work always, but if you find this the difference of numerator and denominator, it means that you have reached halfway through the recurring number of decimals. We don't have to calculate up to so many decimals. So let's say I want to evaluate up to 6 or 8 decimals. So 9 by 39. So I will take 1 more than 3, which is 4. So I divide everything by 4. So this becomes 0. So start dividing 9 by 4. 4 2s are 8. 1 is remainder. 4 3s are 12. Then I have 4 zeros are. See, I got 30. So 39 minus 9 is 30. And I got this 30 here. So which means the next digits will be 9 minus 2, 7. 9 minus 3, 6. 9 minus 0, 9. So the answer is up to 0.230769. And then it will repeat after that. 230769 will repeat again. See how easy it is. One more example. If I was dividing 8 over 79, I take 1 more than this number, which is 8. So I divide by 8. Everything I divide by 8. So 0 point. Now start dividing by 8. I want up to 8 decimals. So after that I can stop. So 8 ones are 8. No remainder. 8 zeros are 0, 10. The 1 is the remainder. So then 8 ones are 8, 2. 8 2s are 16, 5 is the remainder, 8 6s are 48, 4 is the remainder, 8 5s are 40, 6 is the remainder, 8 7s are 56, no, 8 8s are 64, 1 is the remainder, 8 so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I need one more. So 8 2s are 16, 16 2 is the remainder. So up to 4 decimals, this is 8 decimals, this is 10126582. This is how I can very easily calculate the recurring decimals of fractions ending in 9, where the denominator is ending in 9. I've given a few problems to try. Please do try them out. You will also find the workings on the BharatGnyan website. In case you have any clarifications or suggestions, please do write to me. Thank you.